So in December you will find that a lot of matrimony is very busy. dedicated to Ma Durga and Ambal, Lakshmi, Saraswati. The first 3 days are for Durga, so everybody chants the Durga Ashtaka. The next 3 days are for Lakshmi, so everybody prays for welfare of their children, of themselves, of their parents. The last 3 days is very important because it is dedicated to Saraswati. So it finishes on the day of Ayuda Puja or Saraswati Puja, where you worship your tools, your ways of living, the means of living, the land, the food you eat, everything you pray for. Because without all that, how can you survive? Okay? And one more thing, you might have lots of money, but if you don't have the wisdom in your head, then you can make losses in life and you can make wrong decisions. So what Saraswati does is she guides the human beings towards knowledge, the ability to not lose opportunities. If you have an opportunity, especially all youngsters, you are in very competitive times. If you have an opportunity, pray to Saraswati and just seize it. So that is what life is all about. And in southern India, we celebrate it as Guru, where we have all these dolls, you know, from the family heirloom, from mother-in-law's given to some, your neighbor is going off to Delhi, so she's giving you some. Like that, you know, and you make steps. And these steps are always in the odd numbers. Either 3 or 7 or 9 or even 11. Now if you go to Mother Meenakshi temple, the Guru there is 11 steps. From there to there you see Guru. And everybody goes enjoying to the temple to see the Meenakshi, and they sit there and see this wonderful Guru. So even if you are from a middle class or lower middle class, it is good to encourage that you keep a couple of dolls in the house those days, because you admire the aesthetics of it, you know. You just look at those dolls and say, they make you feel good. And that is the thing, the feeling good factor that comes into the house. And this is a complete ladies only club. This is called the Jolly Ladies Club. Navaratri is only for the men. The men only go as drivers. Poor men sit in the car and they wonder, okay, when is my wife going to come out? Well, she will have a compensation because she'll come out with a little bit of shundal and some sweets. The shundal is given because this Ma Durga Ambal, she loves very proteinous food. So you make shundal out of chana, you make shundal out of black chana, you make shundal out of what is that thing called, moong dal, by possible. And then you make shundal out of the full moon dal. Sometimes you mix all those and you give a highly nutritious shundal. Okay? And that shundal is also made famous in Tamil Nadu, especially Madras, because it is called Tenga Maka Patani Shundal, which is sold on Marina Beach. And I think last 40 years I've experienced that. And the shundal is getting better. Because you know what? You have pressure cookers nowadays. Not like the olden days when they put an aluminum pitchy and keep stirring. So in southern India, this is called Guru. In Bengal, it's a big time celebration because they put that Ma. There they don't have number of God. They have only the Durga Mata, which they make a big image of it, okay? And the Durga Mata is sitting there and entire Bengal goes on leave. You call anybody saying, oh, Nahi Aschari. Oh, where is he gone? Ma Durga ki pujo, they say, you know, so you can't make a human being in Calcutta till 9 days are over. And I read in the paper that some 2.800 crores worth of business that goes on in Bengal for Durga Puja. Why? Because discount on clothes, discount on machinery, discount on cars, everything. So for them, you know, it's big time. But this Ma is not alone in the Tanda. They call them Tandas, okay? And I'm digressing from Tamil Nadu Guru to Bengal. Because they make these stunning scenes now. Scenes from the Ramayana, scenes from the Mahabharata. And in the Durga story, they've got some gory scenes where Durga with her big spear is killing Mahishasura in the human form, you know. And gory scene where the blood is all streaming out. Because they go there and they tell the children, see how Durga has killed. So, you know, the children are in fear in their minds, not to do any sins. You know, they just see the car, they say you were there. So they will all feel very happy that they also taught the children a lesson. What took the cake in 2019 when I went to Bengal was they had recreated New York skyscrapers. From here to there, you know, like all beautifully lit. And I said, what's happening? They said, no man, you have to go inside, and then you will find the good. So that gives, scope for their creativity. So what happens in Tamil Nadu? It's a time when a lot of craftsmen are also getting some livelihood. Because as soon as you start putting a golu, you'll call your carpenter to set up the steps or the padi, where the electrician has to come and fix a few bulbs. And then the painter has to come and touch up the old toys or the old dolls. He will bring come armed with his gold paint, because all the crowns and the jewelry has to be painted shiny gold, you know. People don't believe in that subtlety of the West. They don't say everything should look dull and boring. They want things to look very beautiful. You know, that is their thoughts. So all this jolly ladies stuff will start visiting all the houses, and they will mingle with each other and they will ask for the prices of sarees and where can I get the best EMI and how do I make tetaka chutney, you know, like that. They will exchange notes. And that makes it for a very nice bonding between human beings. And I think that was the purpose of this entire goal. Okay. Then I want to go all the way from Calcutta to Japan. See, in the month of late February and March, Japan passes. Japan has its own goal. It's called the Hanimitsu. And there also, for 10 days, they will arrange the dolls of their house, what the mother-in-law, mother, everybody gives. And you can see the Hanimitsu festival being held. But that's end of February till 4th of March. And they like it to coincide with the cherry blossoms. Because you know, they feel very happy that the blossoms are there and that they have the dolls in the house. And if you know Japan, if you know Tokyo, for instance, they live in tiny boxes of houses. So even then they will make an assembly of dolls like that and they will worship them. Then if you have any questions, you can also ask them. These are the pictures. Yeah, this is a remarkable golu in Vesalada. I was talking to you about golu in temples. This is in the Kalikamba temple in town area. They made their own golu and they had a little lovely veena player sitting and playing there. It's all free, everybody can go sit there. But of course they were insisting on distancing and masks.
Paris
Bata. This is also Vesalada. This lady would go to Kosapet and and where they repair the dolls, and she has a huge collection of these are very large Durga, Ambal and Saraswati. Did you see the Japanese guru? That's why when you invite Japanese people to our homes, they feel very happy because it reminds them of their own. And this is just to say that you don't even have to have padi. You can just assemble the dolls that you have. So this lady, she's in her late 70s. She has just put gold paper at the back, made a little red carpet in front, and assembled the dolls that she has. So this is to get the feeling of celebration. Yes.
Thank you for taking the time.
But they also have the parish.
Huh? Oh, they have, yeah, right. Or what number.
Okay, and about your own golu?
I do my own golu, okay. I saw my phone. I have two big Krishnas, okay? Both of them are about 40 years old. So, these two Krishnas I decorate and keep them on a, like a white thing like that. Two steps. Third step I try to put on tiny stone to put another doll. But in my family, we have a family home in Santong where my sister-in-law takes a lot of clubbing and she's got all the family dolls. So she has about, let's say, 25 nice big dolls. And she keeps on adding, you know, we keep telling her, you're getting older, not much more look after these dogs. But then in the old home, they had something called the loft. It's called the paran. Okay? And they would put a ladder and climb there and think, modern houses, we don't have that. By the time we have stuffed our suitcases, there's no space. So anyway, we give excuses. And I want to say that the doll makers of Panmuti, of somewhere near Tanjore, so they put the call in another village. They all come during Navratri and in North Mara streets in Mylapore, which is around the Kapalikovil, they assemble all these dolls and rows, and they are trying to get customers. The nice thing is there is a resurrection of Golu. 7-8 years ago, Golu had faded out. Now children are reading on social media and everything, and so they are asking their mother, aren't we doing this? So they drag their children along and they bargain. If a fellow says a doll is 350, they say, give it to me for 75, please, let it come to me. All these mommies will say, neither chumana ne ettitte ore, paisa ne ettitte ore, nalladu nane, doll ne ettitte ore. So they sit there half a day. You see them, you go there. And another thing, I feel very sorry for them. And I really came home and prayed. Because those crucial days, it rained very badly. So they had all those tarpaulins thrown on the dogs. And the mother, poor thing, their prayer is suffering. And then during the pandemic, they think this year far better than last year. So they wanted to sell the dogs. Last year, they didn't sell much. And another thing is, Kathi Bhagan is taking a lot of interest. They are bringing their dogs and they are assembling very nicely. Pumbuhar is having good sales of dogs. So some of you from North India, when you go home, one of the nice things you can take is a golu dog. The thing is, in the olden days, they made them out of mud. And inside the mud, they had one wire. They fashioned that wire like an image and then they start putting the mud on it, fashion it into a face, arms and everything. And then finally, the golu paint will come. So when your old doll breaks, you know, like our poor Rama in our old house was having one complaint for a long time. Then my grandmother said, oh, let's wrap it in the newspaper, let's hide it nicely. So I said, why don't we put a kurta kind of thing and hide the poor little complaint that was hanging out. Yeah, we didn't resolve it. We stuck a lot of newspaper around and around instead of tape. And then we put a little chiffon top on it and then tie the lines on the vastra so that the Rama looked great. But this is the thing, you know, gentlemen like whom they can afford it. So we have come out of the mud doll phase. Now these are all mud dolls. And we are now coming to papier-mâché, which is a great bone to the scenery. And same thing is happening in Bengal. The papier-mâché, the way they paint it, they can make a doll look like a bronze. They spray the gold on it and then they give the shadings to the Lakshmi and the Saraswati, whatever. And then from far I said, my God, such a big bronze. It wasn't bronze. He said, Didi, a bronze nahi hai. Then kya hai? A papier mache which is painted with the spray gold. You've seen it? No. I'll send a photograph to you. So do you have any questions?
It's wonderful to listen to you because you kind of, you know, put the whole thing together, festival, our people, yeah. The
artists. And why should I not mention our Prime Minister and Home Minister have not come from there? In Gujarat, Navratri is a big celebration of 9 days. For them it's not dogs. For them it's a lot of song and dance. Okay, and they are like free spirits. They step out of the house at 7 o'clock, you won't see them till 11 o'clock in the night. They will be doing the garba. You try to do the garba with the sticks, then in Gujarati you will get burnt. You know, they will be, I don't know, 6 times I learned the steps, I can't do it. There are some basic knowledge of dance. They will move so fast, you know, that they will just hit you and go off. So, better not go near Gujarati, they are champs in them. And that's why in some films, you know, they had the song of the Garba, very, very famous. For them, it's eating Dogla family and all their big sugi and Ola. And also eating a lot of mithai, lots of sweets. Here we are more conservative. I think one mate, one sweet. And, as usual, you know, South Indians have more conscious of the bottom line. So, very should that. But now I read in the Adyar Times, for instance, during Navratri, there were very enterprising women who were saying, you can supply some sugar to your house. So that was good, you know, it is a business opportunity for small vendors and small groups. So best thing, ladies, is to say, enjoy Navratri, believe in yourself, because that is what Durga said, believe in yourself, and dress nicely, be positive, make sure that the other side is green and beautiful and you are heading that way. So thank you, Dashi. So that you can digest all the shunda and stuff. And then, of course, they give you the mirror and the comb to this thing. Then they will give you this little box of kumkum. So, you know, this is a must. This will be there at the entrance, and as you are leaving, the little children of the house will say, Auntie, Auntie, take your pocket. I remember one child came running after the car. And Gemini Ganesha's family. They all have wonderful dogs. And for them, they just have to phone the studio and ask the set designers to come and arrange their dogs. So that they would do it on a very upscale and very nice. But now the family has all become, from a joint family, they've all gone separate. So the tradition of the Gemini household is gone. Gemini house itself is gone. And Dr. Kamala Sendera, she's the daughter of Mr. Gemini Ganesha, she keeps a wonderful guru because she always believed in it.
Okay,
thanks.
Okay. And